Hey everybody, it's John. Welcome over to the shop, except today, well, I'm not in the shop. I'm here in the ham shack. Here in Northeast Texas, we're experiencing that end of the year. This is December of 2018 and about 2 days before the new year, and we're experiencing that same cold the rest of the country is. Perhaps not quite as cold as other parts, but still pretty cold here for Texas. Got another review video for you today. This one, of course, is from Banggood, as the title indicated. And I'm going to take a look at a micrometer, a digital micrometer that Banggood sent over for a review. Before I go in the review, though, just a very brief comment about the comments to videos about product reviews. From time to time, different companies, Banggood is one of them, will send products for me and other YouTube creators to evaluate and review. And they do that at no charge, and they'll send it to us, and actually we get to keep that. And we can say literally anything we want to say about it. In fact, I own the video here, and well, as far as YouTube will let me own the video, I suppose. But I own the video, and it's uploaded to my own personal site, so it doesn't have to go through them to get permission or anything. They can't bring it down. It is whatever I say it is on there. Now, when I do put these videos up, comments are always welcome and encouraged, of course, on all my videos. With one caveat, obviously I've talked about the profanity and off-color language, have zero tolerance for that. I'm not going to get into that right now. What I do want to comment, though, on is, or talk a moment on, are comments specifically on these product review videos. For some reason, a product review, in my opinion, it seems to bring out a lot of internet trolls. And they will come in here and just put a litany of words after word after word after words, either talking about how bad something is or how bad the company is. And, you know, all of a sudden, you know, it may involve space aliens and every other type of thing that goes on. I'm going to reserve the right to just delete those comments. I have no way to prove if those are know if those are true, and they may very well be. I'm not passing judgment. I just have no way to do that. And they may be false. So I'm just going to reserve the option to just delete those comments that are from there. And also, for some reason, the product reviews, especially when they come from overseas, typically, there's one or two people that always want to interject a political comment in there. This is not a political channel. I'm not taking sides on anything that's out through there. This is just a fun thing that I do, and I enjoy working in the shop or here in the ham shack to do that. So from going forward on these product reviews, comments are welcome, but stick to the product that's being reviewed, and don't go off on tangents about politics, or don't go off on tangents about how sorry an individual is, or you know, my cousin's uncle's best friend's brother brought one of those things 47 years ago, and you know, here's what happened to it. That's really not relevant to the product that we're talking about. So enough of that is said. Let's go ahead with the little Banggood digital micrometer review. And first, let's take a look at some screenshots from the website to give an overview about the caliper itself. This is the cover of the screenshot for this particular item, and the title of the item itself in Banggood's catalog is Professional 0 to 25 millimeter Electronic Digital Micrometer with a 1.001 millimeter resolution. One thing that I noticed when I went to the website was the review is a 5-star review. Of course, it only has 13 reviews, but 5 stars with 13 reviews at least gives some credibility. And when you look at the amount sold up this date, and that's as of this video recording, they've sold 172. So they've got about slightly less than 10% of the reviews, and all of those are at 5 stars. So that may give some indication as to the quality of it. You can see the U.S. price here was $42.42. Of course, this price does include shipping from China to the United States. If you're watching this in another country, you would have to use the price conversion and the shipping information for your specific country. Moving on, let's take a look at the description itself. It's showing the features. It says, and I'm reading this right off the website, so this is the conversion between Chinese and English. It says this item is designed to seek smaller measuring errors and professional service. With a resolution of 0.001 millimeter or 0.0005 and an accuracy of 0.002 millimeters, and you can see the rest of it. This item can satisfy your professional needs. We all aspire after beauty, elaboration, and truth together. Have no idea what that means, but it is on the website. Here's some features of it. It's an extra large LCD screen, which you'll see in a minute that is really a pretty large screen on this item. It does have high accuracy. We'll talk about that. Data hold and wipe out, data input. Relative and absolute measuring, tolerance measuring, original or origin resetting. It does come with a wrench for calibration. It does have a fitted wooden protective case. In reality, it does not have a wooden case. It came with a plastic case. Auto search for maximum and minimum values. Have no idea what that feature does. Absolute and relative measuring. That's just a repeat of something it said above. It does have a switch for metric inch conversion, and it does have a satin chrome finish with carbide faces. I don't know too much about that satin chrome finish. It's more of a hammer tone finish, and I have no way to know if it's carbide faces or not. I'm just going to take their word on that. So that's the features. Specifications include a power supply of a SR44 battery. On this screen, it shows not included, but in reality, after I opened it up, I did find one that was included in there. It does have an operating temperature of 0 to 40 degrees centigrade, a storage temperature of minus 20 to 70 degrees centigrade. And it's showing here no influence with wind, relative humidity of less than or equal to 80%. And you can see the dimensions, which are 162 by 57 by 24 millimeters, which is approximate. And I'll show you the inch equivalent of that when I get it on the table here. The package does include the micrometer, and it does include a wrench that goes along with it. And as I said before, it has 13 reviews. Well, this shows 11 customer reviews. The screenshot that I took here was a day or two before I took the cover screenshot that you saw a while ago. So actually, it's put in a couple of more reviews on it since that time. But it is still holding at a 5-star review. So that's enough about the overall specs and description from the website. Now let's take a look at the actual item here on the desk. Well, as you can see, things are pretty crowded here at the workbench, but this is how it arrives. It's the typical packaging that you get when you order the imports. It comes first in the little bag, then wrapped in the cellophane, and then you get the box that the caliper comes in, which is the typical plastic box. It does have these little blow mold hinges in it, which if you're going to use this box a lot, probably will not have the life that some of the other boxes have. On the other hand, it is a caliper, so you're probably just going to keep it on your workbench. It does come with some instructions. The instructions are all in Chinese, but if you're used to using a micrometer, you really are not going to need these. But there is, I see no English whatsoever on the instructions at all. So let's take a look at what comes in the box itself. And of course, you do get the caliper, and there is a wrench that comes with it. And speaking of the wrench, let's first take a look and see how it lines up. Not that it's really going to matter a great deal because it is a digital caliper, but it's always good to just see if we do get a line up with the zeros. And that is pretty close on the money right there. If I pull it down with a ratchet, it may be half a line off of those engraved lines. So it's not right on it, but they did take pretty good care. Now, if you've never adjusted a micrometer, there's plenty of videos that are out there on how to do this, but it's very, very easy. This mandrel right here is just a press fit in there, and you just take this little wrench and you actually twist that around until you get it to line up to where it is. So it is very easy if yours does come off, but this one right here is pretty accurate as it goes. Now, as I said, there's no instructions that come with this that are in English, but let's take an overall look at just the construction and some of the things that it does have. At first glance, it is a rather large micrometer compared to some of the manual micrometers. By manual, I mean the one that does not have this dial. As you can imagine, when you put that dial that's, you're looking here, something that's about an inch and 3/4, this part right here on that screen, if you eliminate that, you probably take all the way, probably 3/4 of an inch off that of the overall length, which actually the overall length is slightly over 6 inches. This is a 6-inch rule, and top to bottom distance is a little over almost between 2 and 3/8 of an inch, it looks like, from one side to the other. It does have a large dial on it. The dial is approximately, and I'm just looking at the screen itself, approximately inch and a half or an inch and 5/8 that way. And it's 3/4 of an inch going that way. It does have, this is in English, so we do have the on-off inch metric, and I'm not sure what that is, INC, but I do know what set is, and that's where you do an artificial zero or a set zero on it. Now, it did say it did not come with batteries, so we'll take a look right here. The battery door is on the back. It is covered with a plastic battery door cover. Well, it does have a battery in it, contrary to what it said in the description. It does have a battery. So since I've got the battery out, one of the things I like to take a look at is just look down in there and check for any corrosion that may have happened on the boat over here. But this one right here does look clean, and the battery itself looks like it is no corrosion. So that's always a plus. The battery fits in there adequately. I've seen better batteries fit, but that does seem to fit in there adequately. It does have this little plastic battery cover. Not a big fan of plastic battery covers, but on these things that are built to be a price, built to a price point, you have to make some sacrifices, I guess, along the way. That battery compartment, I would just call that barely good. I would like to have a more secure snap when that battery lid went on it, but it does not protrude. It is, you know, there's no protrusion, so there's nothing to hang on. So I'm assuming that that would probably, or I'm going to take my chance that that would be in there and held pretty securely. It does have a lock on it. Let's check the lock. So we do have a battery. So on metric, we go down 3 digits, and on inches, it goes down 4 digits. So we're going tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths, and half of ten thousandths. Or actually, we're going down to tenths of ten thousandths, or half of ten thousandths, I guess is where it measured. So that's getting some pretty consistent measurements right there. Now, I've got it set on ten thousandths. So again, our dot is right here. So let's bring it on down. Let's check for consistency as we move up and down and go back and see if we can hit the zero each time. Hit it that time, and I'm using the ratchet right here. All right, it came off, that's 1/10,000. That's not a thousandth, that's a tenth. A 10,000th is what we're looking at. Now we're back into zero again. Back to zero again. So that's pretty good for itself. Let's take a look and see how accurately it does measure compared to some Joe blocks that I have here. So let's take a Joe block here and come in and see how we came in. Well, the Joe block read at 170,000, and I'm reading 107 1/10,000. So I'm going to call that pretty accurate, especially for a home shop. Let's try this one, which reads at, it looks like 3,000. I don't have my optimizer, but we'll see. 300,000 is what it looks like it read at. Let's see if that's right. Yeah, that reads at 300,000 and 3/10. So, but remember, these are Joe blocks. They're not precision, and they may have some dirt or corrosion on them also. Let's try one here that's, that one reads 600,000. We'll go up the scale here and just see how everything reads. And I'm chasing that thing down here. All right, 600,000, we're off 4/10,000. So, when you're working in a home shop, very few people I would think would be working at the 10,000 in the home shop. So we're well within, say, a half a 10,000 for measurements on that, going all the way up to 600,000. So now let's bring it back down and let's see if it zeroes out. And we zeroed from 600,000 down. We went to 2, brought it back out. We got to 1/10,000. Remember, guys, that's 10,000. That's not a thousandth. Our decimal is still over here at this point right here. Take a look at some other features that we have. Move these Joe blocks out of the way and get back in the screen a little bit. Let's take a look at the mandrel lock and see how secure it is. And that's a pretty secure lock. You do have to turn it quite a ways. Now, that is a plastic lock, so that's an area that could be potential problems down the road, but for right now, it does lock very securely. On the other hand, it is attached with a slotted screw head, so I suppose you could make another one if by any chance something would happen to that plastic one. The rod itself seems to be really smooth. And by the way, I didn't even check to see if it had any dirt or anything or anything that would mess that up, but I did zero it out before I started. It does have these little plastic things on each side of it, and what that's for, if you've ever wondered about it, that's where you hold it, especially if you've got a big variance in temperature like we would have today and I was out in the shop. You hold it on these plastic pieces, and that would prevent the body temperature from having any effect on what you're using or what you're measuring for. Before I let you go, we'll take a look right here at the display and see how tall those numbers are. And I'll use that one as my reference. So the numbers themselves are about a half inch tall. So the visibility on it, of course, is very good. And the markings along the side, I'm not real sure they're etched. I think they may be lasered on there. I can't feel anything with my fingernail. But probably for the home shop use, that would last for a very, very long time. The switch is very secure on it. It goes back and forth real easily. Now, I did notice when I was messing with it a while ago, I did not see this light go out or the display go out. Now, I can't tell by here because this is all in Chinese, but I did not notice that. So if the case is the display does not go out, you're going to always need to be conscious to cut it off. And I left it on probably for about a minute a while ago as I was reaching back to hunt the ruler. And when I came back, that was still on. Now, it does hold its setting. All right, so now we got 162. Let me cut it off. And I'll cut it back on. Let's see if it held that. It did. Now, if I need to set that at zero, you do a long press. There it goes. And it goes back to zero. It bounces back and forth, but it toggles. There it is. So it just toggles back and forth between the zero, and it's one of those short press, long press type things. You kind of have to hit it just right and hold your mouth a little bit, but there it goes. The more you do it, the better you'll get with it. So that about wraps up this review on this little caliper that Banggood sent over. Some final thoughts. I think it's a pretty nice little caliper. It came complete. It works fine. It seems to be really accurate and would have a place in your home shop. And I think the price point is about right on it. It does everything that you'd ask for. Would I recommend it as the only caliper that you would have? Maybe I would not go that far based on this one reason, and that is the size of it. This is quite a bit larger than, say, just a regular standard old-school micrometer without the dial on it, because they're just a whole lot smaller. If you're working on very small engines or very small projects in your home shop, you might find this a little bit too big to reach down in some of those spaces that you're working with to take some of those small measurements. But with that being said, if you're looking for just a general purpose, probably 95% of the time that you're going to just need to measure something and measure it accurately, I would recommend this micrometer here. I think I've called this thing a caliper several times through there, but it is a micrometer, and it's a digital readout on it. So until next time, I want to thank Banggood for supplying these things for my channel and other creators that are out there, and we hope to continue doing some of these. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Go ahead and like the channel. Doesn't cost anything to do that, and it kind of helps us in the ratings as things go. Until next time, this is John, Tinker John, and we'll catch you back here in the shop.